Audit.
Yeah, started. Okay, so first today's session we are going to see core Java. In core Java we are going to see what is Java and where is Java is used and why Java is used, and then we will see some history of Java. Then we'll see some internals of Java program, what are all the things they have used inside the Java. Then we will see some the difference between JDK, JRE and JVM, followed by classes and objects, methods, method overloading, static method, constructor, this keyword, abstract class, interface, and the use of buffered reader, exception handling, and so on. So you no need to worry about anything because I'm going to do everything as a hands-on session. So, okay. So what is Java? Like Java is a, it's a programming language. You can see in my slide, Java is a programming language which can able to develop many applications like web applications. Then we can create a GUI applications and so many things. And it's a platform independent language. That means you can run Java in any operating system. For example, let us say your company using Windows for developing an application. But if you want to run that application for Linux, you can do it because Java is a platform independent. And Java is an object-oriented programming language also, because we know that initially the programming language starts with C. And then they have included the support of OOPS concept, and they have introduced something called C++. And in C++, we'll implement some of the OOPS concepts like classes, objects, and etc. But the main drawback of C++ is like they can't able to use in web application. So what they have introduced is something called Microsoft Visual Basic, then Microsoft Visual thing like ASP.NET and everything they have used in Sun Microsystem. Sorry, it's used in Microsoft. So in Java side, they have started with a core Java, then they have moved with J2EE, then J2ME, and so many things. So we'll learn everything. And Java is compiled and interpreted.
Unmute layer.
So let me mute all the audios. Okay. So I'm going to explain what is platform independent. C is a platform dependent language. For example, when you compile a C program in Windows operating system, you can able to run that only in Windows operating system. You can't able to run that in Linux operating system, but you have to, after writing the C program, what you can do is you can compile it in Linux and you can run it, but you can't directly execute that C program in Linux. So in Java, what we can do is we can write a program with an extension called .java, and there is a compiler. Compiler is nothing but it will convert the human readable language into a machine readable thing. So what we'll do is we'll write a Java program, we will compile it, and we will make sure that this Java file is converted into a dot class file. And this dot class file is a platform independent file. That means we can run this dot class file in any operating system like Mac or Microsoft or Unix or Linux. The reason is they have a common thing called JVM, that is Java Virtual Machine. So this Java Virtual Machine is nothing but it's a platform that it can able to run the Java application in any operating system. But yeah, well, what the operating system is doing now is when you install the operating system itself, the JVM is installed so that you can install Java in any operating system. So that is like Java is an platform independent. So we'll go into some history. And so, you know, this Java was started by this person called James Gosling during the year 1996. Actually, the history of Java begins like this. It was started in June 1991. And initially, they used C++ for designing the application. But what they have found is C++ is more complex to write, and it is not platform independent, because their aim is to implement a project called Green. So which is an embedded project, which is not able to implement it with the help of C++. So the person called James Gosling, Mike Sheridan, and Patrick Norrington has developed a new language called Java. And initially the name of the Java is not Java, it is Oak. So the name Oak represents the tree outside the Sun Microsystem laboratory. So they have given the name as Oak. And later they found that they can implement some new name. So they have given the name as Java. Any case about Java, because Java is a coffee bean, what they will use in a coffee shop. This people, James Gosling, Mike Sheridan, and Patrick Norrington, what they will do is they will go and have a coffee in the coffee shop. In that coffee shop, they use Java bean. It's a coffee bean. So what they have decided is, yeah, we can name our programming language as Java like that. And so this Java is like runs once and run anywhere, or we can call it as warm. So warm is nothing but runs one, write once and run many. That means we can write a Java program only once, we can compile it, and we can run in any operating system. So that's all about the history and the concepts of Java. And we'll see about JDK and JRE and JVM. So JDK stands for Java Developers Kit. So it's Java Developers Kit. So it is used to develop an application in Java. And JRE is nothing but Java Runtime Environment. It is used to run the application in Java. And what is JVM? So JVM is nothing but it is a machine, or it is an architecture which can able to run Java in any operating system. So these are the theories behind the Java. And we will directly go into implementation of Java. And maybe I can take some 5 minutes for a discussion. So if you have any questions or queries, you can ask me now. So I will unmute you all. Do you have any queries or questions? Or shall we proceed? You have any queries, you can ask me now. You have any queries?
Nothing, sir.
Yeah, nothing or what? Okay, so we'll proceed. Okay, so before that I will mute everyone. Okay, so we'll go to the programming thing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a folder in desktop. Say it is Java, or you can put as class 1. So first we have to check whether the Java is installed in our machine. So first what I can do is I can go to C. So then I can go to program files. There you can see a Java folder. And I have installed Java 1.8.0. And now we have a latest version of Java, that is JDK 1.10. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with JDK 1.8 and slowly I'm going to move to JDK 1.9. then JDK 1.10, like that. So, but it is better to start with JDK 1.8. So initially what in my, when I did my college, I started with like JDK 1.4, but many classes and many methods were not available for today's version of Java because it has been taken out for some valid reason. And that's all. So we'll start. So this is JDK 1.8 folder. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open that. Then you can see many folders like bin, db, include, jre, lib. So this bin folder contains all the executable versions of Java. Like if you want to run the Java, you can use Java exe command. If you want to compile the Java, you can use Java c.exe command. And if you want to have some header thing, you can use Java h. Then if you want to get the abstract version of a class, you can use Java p. Then so many things are there. So we are not going to do any modifications here. Or if you want to execute the applet, you can use the applet viewer. And this DB will have some predefined or built-in packages. We are not going to touch into it. And this lib, where there are so many jar files must be used to run this application. So I'm not going to use, or I'm not going to touch upon this. Okay, so this is JDK. So if you want to, if you want to create a Java application, we can use JDK this folder. Or if you have already a program with you, and if you have already a executable part of Java with you, you can use JRE, and this JRE will have the same thing of execution of Java like that. So the goal is like JDK 1.8 is to create a Java application, and this JRE 1.8 is to run the Java application. So I'm going to make a path for this. So I'm going to inside the bin folder, I'm going to copy this. So I'm going to go to my computer. So then I'm going to select properties. Then I'm going to use advanced system setting, then environment variables. Then I can click on new. Then I can type path. Then I'm going to paste the location of the bin folder in Java. Then I can put semicolon. Then I have to select the OK button. The reason we are doing is we have installed Java in our machine, and we want to make sure that the system should understand that where we have installed Java. So we have installed Java in C program files, Java, JDK 1.8, bin, so many things, stuff like this. And we are setting that as the path. So the system will understand the path of the Java is this. Since I have already set the path, so I'm not going to select this OK. So when you select OK, you can see the path has been set. So select OK, then again OK, then again OK. So this you have already did in your prerequisites. So to check whether the Java is installed in our machine, I can go to command. So I can simply type Java space hyphen version. So this indicates the Java is installed in our machine. So this also displays the version of Java, that is 1.8.0_171, and it also specifies some of other steps also. So it is good that we are going to start a Java program. Before that, we have set the path and everything. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create an application in this folder Java, class one, and I'm going to compile it with the help of this command line. Okay, so before that, let me resume recording. Okay, so now I'm going to write a Java program. So inside this class one, so I'm going to create a new text document. So I'm going to open this. So before writing a Java program, let me start with the basic structure of C. So in C, we will use hash include, the header file stdio.h, then void main or int main. Then we will use something called printf to print something. Okay. So instead of void main, you can also use int main, and this will be the basic structure of C. And the same way, the C++ also will have some iostream.h, Then again, void main. So instead of printf, we can have cout. Like this. So this in C, this is said to be a header file, and this is said to be a main method or main function. And here in C++, this is said to be a main header file, or this is said to be our main method. In Java, it is like everything in Java is said to be a class. So we can start with class, followed by class name. So let me increase the font size. So in Java, everything is said to be class. So I'm going to create my first program. So I'm going to name it as first. And the main thing in class name is it has to be start with a capital letter. So even though if you use small letter, it will work, but it will work only for some core Java application. But when you go for an advanced version of Java, it is mandatory that the first character of the class name should be in capital letter. The reason is, they have like a predefined class name, which is the first character is capital letter. So in Java, it is must that the first character of Java should be in capital letter. That is the pattern, the design pattern they have given. And similar to C, they have something called void main. But in Java, they will have something like public static void main. And this specifies this as the current, this as the main method. And you know, like in Java, when you give anything as input, it will be taken as the string format. So this main method takes only the argument as string data type. And we can take any number of arguments. So we can have like a string array, you can put args like this. And in C, you'll use something called printf to print. And in C++, you'll use cout. In Java, it is like system.out.println. So this system is a predefined class of Java. So you can see the first character is capital letter, followed by the out method, and again printf println method, followed by the information we want to print. So this is the very simple first program of Java. Like we have to start with class, followed by the class name. We have to make sure that the first character of the class name should be capital letter, and this is the main method, like public static void main. And Java supports only, like Java, it can take only input as string. So it can take any number of strings. So we have to use string array. So this is the string array version. Or in olden style, we can put like this also. So string followed by arguments, you can put anything like here. You can put first or second or anything like that. But normally they will put args. Args is nothing but arguments. Then if you want to print something, we have to use system.out.println, where system is a predefined class, out is a method, and println is another method. And this is the parameter for that println, that is hello world. So now we are going to save this file. So I'm going to save. And what we have to save is, we have to save this as first.java. It should be the same name as the class name. So first.java, I'm going to select save as type all files, and I'm going to select save. What I have did is, I have created something called first.java. So I'm going to just copy this location, and I'm going to put this in command. So cd followed by the location. When I press enter, you can see this, it is located in C user files, followed by some desktop or the folder thing. So if I type dir, it will display what are all the contents inside this directory. Maybe first.java like this, a new text document. So this is the first thing I am going. What I have did is I have created the program called first.java. So I am going to compile this. So compilation is nothing but it will convert the human readable program into a machine readable thing. So in Java, there is a compiler called Java C compiler, which will convert this Java file, for example, the first.java file into something like first.class. You can see this first.java is compiled into first.class. So to execute the Java, I'm going to use Java followed by the class name. So you can see the Java name is file.java and the class name is file. So I'm going to run Java followed by first. We should not put first.java because we are just specifying the class file. And then I'm going to press enter. And there we go. We are getting the hello world as the result. So let me explore this first.class. So this is first.java we have written. This is in the form of human readable format, that is in high level language. And this is first.class. This is like a it is said to be an object file. It is not it's not in the human readable version. And one more concept I want to tell you, like in Java, like when you have a class file, if you see the first four character of Java, it is unique for all the class name. So what does this represents? This, it's like capital E, then small p, then small o, or 3/4. What this represents? So this represents the magic number of Java. So this magic number of Java, let me explore this one. And this is this magic number. So it is in the form of ASCII value. So let me copy this ASCII value and I'm going to convert into a hexadecimal value. Let me see what happens. So I'm going to give ASCII to hexadecimal code online. So I'm going to give ASCII text. So I'm going to paste the first four character of Java. If I give convert, it will give you the magic number of Java. So the magic number of Java is kfbabe. So it's a hexadecimal number which can be represented in all the class files. Even though if you create some Java web application, you can see this magic number. Or if you create some Android-based mobile application, you can see this class magic number. Or if you create anything in Java, this will be the magic number in which many of the developer or the programmer, they don't know this magic number. It will be a very good thing. Like, you should know about this magic number. Maybe you can go to your college or you can go to your company and you can ask your friends, what is magic number of Java? They can't be able to explore that in internet because it is not available in internet also, but it is very good to you to know that this magic number of Java is kfbabe. Okay, so any doubt so far? Maybe I can take some 5 minutes for some interaction. Any doubt? Hello? Yeah.
So throughout the class, we will use this text document for writing coding, or else we will use some application like Eclipse, like that.
Yeah, for core Java, initially I'm going to start with Notepad, because if you are a fresher or if you are basic to Java, it is good that we have to start with Notepad. Later, okay. I will go to some ID called IntelliJ ID. It is very good integrated development environment. So this IntelliJ ID I'm going to use, in which it is very easy for your naming convention also. Eclipse also, it is very good to use, but I am used to IntelliJ because IntelliJ, it is it can be integrated with GitHub, or it can be integrated with many extra thing also. So I will be using IntelliJ as the day progress, or as the class progress. Maybe after 3 days of the class, I will be using this IntelliJ. Any other doubts, guys? Any other doubts? Or shall I proceed to the next thing?
Like Sujata asking one thing in chat.
Okay.
Like she is asking, every Java, do we need to create a class file and Java file?
Yeah, it is. When you create a Java file, when you compile it, it will be generating the class file for you. So this Java file is a human readable file. That is, we are hard coding the code and we are compiling with the help of Java compiler. The Java compiler will create a class file for you. Okay. So any other doubt, you can type it in group chat, so that I can take for a minute, then I can proceed for the next thing. Yeah, this Visual Studio won't be used. The next question is, won't we use Visual Studio? This Visual Studio is only like, it can be applicable for some Microsoft products like C Sharp or Visual Studio or ASP.NET, like that. So we are not going to use Visual Studio, but instead of Visual Studio, we are going to use IntelliJ IDE. In Visual Studio, like everything, it will be integrated, and that is only applicable for a Microsoft application. What we are going to do is, we are going to create a Java application. So we can either use Eclipse or we can use IntelliJ. But I prefer to go for IntelliJ. So anything? Okay, let me ask you. Yeah. Can we run the dot class file without, yeah. So I'm going to delete this first.java. So I'm going to delete this first.java. Okay. So the question is, I have created a Java file only once. I have compiled the Java file, and the Java file now is converted to first.class. What I can do is, I can copy this file and I can put it in Linux operating system. And in Linux operating system, without compiling the first step, like without Java C first.java, I can directly run Java first. So this is the concept of WARM, that is, write once and run many. Okay. Is that okay, or is there any questions? Okay, good. So I will start with some small quiz, so that make sure that everyone is online. So just open your chat and I will ask some questions, like, okay. So what is the initial name of Java? So that is the question. Your answer, it should be, you should type that in group chat. Okay, good. Okay. Why it is named as oak? Yeah. The name of oak is not a coffee tree. Is a tree outside Sun Microsystem. So initially the name of the Java is green, go green, and they want to name some different name. So they went outside the Sun Microsystem office. They found a tree which is very older tree and it is very stronger also. So they have specified the name as oak initially. But later they also found that the old is also, oak is a very old name, and they want to change the name to some other name. So they went to the coffee shop and they were just thinking about the new name, and they can't able to identify any name. So while they're having a coffee, they found that the coffee bean is Java, and so they named it as Java. Okay, so Java is a coffee bean and oak is a tree. Okay, and one more question or one more quiz. I think there is a country or a city, I don't know. There is a country called Java. You can explore it. What is the capital of Java? You can explore it in internet and you can put it in chat. So this is not included. This is not related to our syllabus. This is just for fun. So the question is, there is a country called Java. I don't know if it's a country or a city. But Java is a city, or Java is an island. It's located in Indonesia, and where in that island they are speaking a new language called Javis, and it's an Indonesia thing, and the capital of Indonesia is Jakarta. Okay, and I'm going to tell you this: Jakarta plays a major role because they have created something called Jakarta Apache Tomcat, which we will learn in J2W application. So this Jakarta is a capital of Indonesia. So there they have created that application. So Jakarta Apache Tomcat, we will learn that in J2W class. Okay. So I think everything is clear, and we'll go to the next topic. So the next topic is, so we have seen Java, history of Java, internals of Java program, then JDK, JRE, and JVM. So then we will see some of the concepts of classes and objects. So what we have did is, we have created something called FIRST. Okay, so we have created something called FIRST. So let me save this. First.java. Okay. So I'm going to create a class, and I'm going to create an object, and I'm going to execute that. So this is a class which doesn't have any object. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to create a new class. For example, class student, and I'm going to add a public static void main. You don't need to worry about the static because we will learn something called static method in this class, maybe later. So the string args, I think, who is scribbling my thing? I don't know, maybe I should stop. Then I should shut up. Okay. So let me start with, so this is the basic program: class student, public static void main, string args, like that. So this student is the class name, and this student will have like data member and member method. So this data member, or before we have some quiz so that it will be very interactive. So when you want to create the quizzes, when you create a sentence, or how will you create a sentence? In English, or how will you create a proper sentence in English? So you can use the chat and you can type your answer. So this is very much related to this class. How will you create a proper sentence in English? Anyone? So the using a proper proper tense pattern, meaningful words, using alphabets. I think using sense subject followed by verb. Yeah. So I got the answer, like it's subject followed by verb. So if you want to form a sentence in English, you should have a proper noun and verb. So noun represents the subject. It may be a person name or age or the ID, etc. The verb represents the action words. So this is very much related to this class because the data member represents the noun. The data member represents the noun and member method represents the verb. Okay. So consider we have a student class. So can you just put some of the nouns can be used for student class in your chat? What are all the nouns can be used for a student class? Maybe I am the student. What are all the subject which I will have? Yeah, name. Yeah, the name is one thing. Then, yeah, maybe a roll number, register number, marks, and so many things. Okay. So let me start with creating some noun. So I will put some something called string name. So in Java, the string is not a data type, it's a class. So I will explain that later to you. So every class must be start with a capital letter. So string name, I can put mark. So mark is nothing but, it's not a string, it's a number. So I can put int mark. Then I can put some like place. So place is nothing but again a string like that. So this is said to be a data member of a class. Now tell me, what are all the verbs that we can put for a class called student? So you can type it in your chat. Verbs are nothing but action words. So you can do it. What are all the verbs can be specified? Like, yeah, you can put add, sub, like extracurricular activities, you can put it in noun. Yeah, you can put it in here also. Average, yeah, average, okay. Okay, daily activities, total, okay. Okay, so for example, if you have like mark 1, mark 2, mark 3, mark 4 like that, if you want to take a total, you can use something called total or like that. But the main verb, it will be like, it's like get name, or you can put set name. Setting and getting are said to be an action words. So it can be also like we can put. For what I'm going to do is I'm going to create something called get details. So get details, it's one of the verb. So I'm going to make this as public. So public, and this I'm not going to return anything. So I'm going to just put void. So again, I will explain this void later, but just let me let you understand. We are just going to use void. So first I have created a data member. Then I will put a verb. So public void get details. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get all the details. So with the help of system.out.println. So first I'm going to display name. So I'm going to display mark and place. Name, mark, place. Okay. So let me save this as student.java. So the verb is nothing but member method. And one more thing I want to like cover. So if we have a data member and a member method, which is closed with this student, then this concept is said to be an encapsulation. So encapsulation is nothing but process of having data member and member method in a single unit. So every class is said to be encapsulated. Okay, so this is the thing I want to convey, like the process of having data member and member method in a single unit is said to be encapsulation. So every class in Java is said to be a concept of encapsulation. Okay, so what we have did is we have created a data member and member method in Java, and what we are going to do is we are going to assign some value for this. To assign that, we have to create something called the object. So for example, student is the class, and I am going to create an object called college student, or you can put CS, college student, equal to new student. So this is how we can create a class, or this is how we can create an object in Java, that is class name followed by any object name equal to new. New is a keyword, and we can put followed by some class name. So student followed by the object CS equal to new class. So using this object, I can put like CS dot name equal to XYZ, then CS dot mark equal to 100. So I am putting double quotes because it's a string data type, and every string data type, it must be double quoted. And I'm putting 100 as without double quotes because it's a integer, and I can put CS dot place as Chennai like that. Now what happens is it will assign the value of name, mark and place for this particular student called CS object, and we can display this content with the help of the getDetails method. So we can put CS dot getDetails. That's it. So after assigning the values to the name, mark and place, what it will do is it will assign this here, and here, and we can print with help of cs.getDetails, and we can do it. Okay, so I'm going to call the command prompt again, and I'm going to just type dir, so make sure that the student.java is there. So I'm going to compile it. Student.java. Yeah, it is now. I think the class files will be generated, that is student.class. So now I'm going to run it. So Java student. Yeah, now you will get the content, the name followed by the mark followed by the place. So let me want to like add a label, like what is this? This is name, this is the mark, and this is the place. So I'm going to type some information. So the information, like we can put it in system.out.println. So the name is followed by the name XY. So this is the string, the name. This is the default one. The name is followed by this XYZ. So we can concat with help of this plus operator. So the name is the information, and this name is this XYZ. Then again, the mark is plus mark. Then the place is plus place. So I'm going to, since I have modified the program, I'm going to compile it. And I'm going to execute this. So Java followed by student. Yeah, now you can see the name is, the mark is, the place. So if you want to put some space, you can put here. So that you will get some proper result. Okay. Okay. So any doubt in this? Let me just revise. The class in Java is nothing but it will have a data member and it will have a member method, and data member is nothing but noun and member method is nothing but verb. Consider this is the student where we can put name, mark and the place as the noun. And for example, this member method is nothing but some action word, so you can put get details. So I'm getting all the details. Then I'm going to create a class, object. So class followed by object equal to new class. Then we can put this, assign this value, object name dot the data member name followed by value. Again, this one. So similarly, I can get the member method with the help of cs.member method name. Okay. So this is all about, so past 20 minutes, we have learned what is class, what is method, how we can assign value to a method, or how we can create an object like that. So if you have any doubt, you can put it in chat now, or we can proceed later to the quiz. Okay. Any doubt in this classes and methods? Okay, the output path is system.out.println. Yeah. Yeah, to print something in Java, we have to use system.out.println. In core Java, we have to use that. Okay. So, so I will start with some quiz again. So the first question is, in C sharp we have a namespace or similar to packages in Java. So we'll see that later. So namespace, in C sharp you'll use console.writeline, something like that. So it is, the console.writeline is similar to system.out.println. So you'll use using console like that. In C sharp you'll use using console as the package. But the one more thing I want to include, here, like there is no header files were included in Java in this file, but normally this system class is a predefined class. It is located in some header files or packages in Java, which is automatically done by Java. For example, let me explain this. So this is student.java and this is class, and I am going to explore what is inside the student. So I am going to type something called Java p followed by student. Yeah, you can see this name is of type string, which is located in java.lang.string. This place is again a string, which is located in java.lang package. But we have not included the java.lang package here. But what the Java it will do is it will include this kind of basic packages automatically when you compile it. And we can see public void get details, then public static void min. So this Java P provides the abstract concepts or abstract description about the student. And one more thing, what is this student indicates? So we have seen name, we have seen mark, and we have seen place, and we have seen get details, and we have seen public static void main. What is the student represents? Anyone? So this student represents, we'll see that in chat. this student represents the class name, but this class name is not this one. So if you have something similar to class name here, for example, it will be when you see like this, what is this one? When you see any method with the same name as a class name, what is this one? Yeah, it is a constructor. So what Java it will do is, when you write a program without any constructor, it will add a default constructor like this. Okay, so in interview they may ask you a question, what is mean by default constructor? Default constructor is nothing but when you create any class in Java without any constructor, the Java will include an automatic constructor without any arguments. You can see there is no arguments, it is just a student and open parenthesis and close parenthesis. So if you don't include any constructor in Java, the Java compiler itself will add a constructor into it. It is said to be a default constructor. Okay. So that's all about the classes and objects. So let me start with a quiz. So tell me what is meant by class. You can type your answer in the chat. What is meant by class in Java? It's a collection of objects. It's a textbook definition. In simple terms, what is class? Okay, under class we will write program, but the class is nothing but it's a collection of data member and member method. Data member is nothing but nouns, and member method is nothing but verb. Okay. So when we have a class, with the data member and member method, then it is said to be encapsulation. Okay. So the next question is, how will you create an object in Java? Okay, what is the syntax? I am asking, what is the syntax? Okay, so class name followed by the object name equal to new class name. Okay, and how will you assign the value to the data member of a class? So cs dot data member name equal to value, cs dot another data member name equal to value, like that we can assign. Okay, good. Okay, so what is the command is used to compile a Java program? Okay, good. What is the command to execute the Java program? Okay. What is the command to get the abstract information about the class? Okay. That's good. Okay. I think you guys are going really well, and you are able to understand the concepts in a really good manner. Okay, so if you have like any question related to this class and objects, maybe we can take for 2 minutes and then we can go for the next topic. So if you have any queries, you can put it in chat. If you have no queries, you can type that also. That will be fine. Shall we move to the next topic? Yeah. Okay, good. So next one, so we have already see how the class, how the Java file is like that. Then we have seen how to create a method like get details like that. Now you see like when you create some like method, for example, get details, consider it is, in our example, it is get details. So when you create some method, it will be available in stack. And also when you create an object, it will be available in stack. But the memory of the object will be allocated in a data structure called heap. So in interview, they may ask like this also, like what is the concept of stack and heap in Java? When you create any method or any object, the object references will be made in with the help of stack and heap. And in Java, there is one more thing called garbage collection. So where is the slide? So in Java, there is a concept of garbage collection where when there is no use of object, it will automatically delete it from your heap. Yeah. So in Java, there is something called garbage collection, which will be performed automatically in Java. When there is no scope in object, it will delete that automatically. So that you have to, like, there is a concept. Okay. Okay. Okay, so let me move to the next topic. So we have seen classes, objects, and methods. Now we will see how to assign the value through the method. For example, so what I have did is I have created a method called getDetails, and using this getDetails, and I have just print the value. So I'm going to create one more method called public void setDetails. So this setDetails, what I'm going to do is I'm going to assign the value here itself. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete this one. So maybe I will create a parameter here, string n for name and int m for mark, then string p for place. And what I will do is I will assign here name equal to n, mark equal to m, place equal to p. Okay, so this is another method called set detail, which will set the value. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set the value of n, m, p. The set detail can be done like this. So cs dot set details. So the name is xyz, then the mark is 100, and the place is Chennai. So first, what it will do is it will set the details. So the name n, the xyz is assigned to n, and 100 is assigned to m, and Chennai is assigned to p, and this will be assigned to name, mark, and place. So let me compile this again. Oh, there is an error. So we have to put a semicolon here. Yeah, you'll get the same result. So the difference between the previous one and this one is In the previous case, I have just assigned, I have just used the object cs.name equal to xyz, cs.mark equal to 100, cs.place equal to Chennai like that. What I have did is I have created something called method, and using that method, I have passed the parameter xyz, 100 and Chennai using the new parameter name m and p. And using this name n, m and p, I have passed to these data member name, mark and place. So I'll be getting the same result. So what happens if you use something like this name, mark and place? Again, name, mark, place. So I'm compiling and I'm not going to execute this until you guys guess what will be the result. Can you just type in your chat what may be the result you'll get? So the result you may get, like for example, if you use the same data member name, like name, mark and place, what the result you'll get when you print this? What is the result you will get when you print this? You can type in your chat. So multiple declare is, it's an error actually. I have compiled it, but there is no error. What is the value you will get when you use the same data member name in the method parameter name? Any guesses? So what many, no, there won't be any runtime error and it won't print any name value, or it won't print any same values or something like that. Just try it. It's not about the correct or incorrect answers. So you can type whatever comes in your mind, you can type. Yeah, we'll just check whether it is null or it is same value. Okay, so now let me execute this one. So I will use Java student. What I will get is, I will get name is null, mark is zero and place is null. So why we are getting the null for name and place? Why we are getting this null for name and place? And why we are getting zero for mark? You can type your answers in your chat. What is the reason we are getting name as null and mark as zero? Okay. So why, like, what is the data type of name is like string and mark is integer? Why we are getting like null, zero? For mark it is zero and for name it is null. Okay. So, you know, like in Java, the name and place, or here in this program, the name and place are string. String is not a data type in Java. It is a string. It is a class in Java. So when you create any object in Java and without assigning it, you will get null. For example, name and place are using string class, so it is not assigned with a value, because when you use name equal to name, mark equal to mark and place equal to place, this name is assigned with the name and mark is assigned with the mark and place is assigned with the same value, which is not a new value, which will not take this name, which will just take this, and it will assign null for name and place. And initially, and this is for the class string, and for integer, there is no value defined for mark. So you will get zero as the default value for integer. So you will get, the string name and place as null and mark as zero. So what you can do is to avoid this. So there is a keyword called this. this.name = this.mark = this.place. Let me check. Yeah, when you use this keyword, you will get the result, because this specifies the current instance. So this.name specifies this here, and this name specifies this. Similarly, this.mark specifies this one, and this mark specifies this one. Similarly, this.place specifies this place, and this right hand side place specifies this one. So using this, when you encounter when you have a same name as the data member name and the method name, you have to use this keyword. So this specifies the current instance of a class. Okay. So any doubt so far in class, object, and these keywords? Any doubt? You can put it in chat so that it can be visible for everyone. Any doubt in classes and objects? Guys, is this a default way to write a Java? Yes, this is one of the way to write a Java. Yeah. What happens is you can see, so here I have given set details, get details, like that. But when you go further into a Java thing, what you can do is you can automatically create setters and getters. So this is said to be a setter method, and this is said to be a getter method. And what you can do is, what the Java IDE it will do is, it will give a get name, get mark, set name, set mark, like that. So yeah, this is the way in which we have to write Java methods. Yeah, suppose I will try that. So I'm going to put this dot name equal to this dot name. Now we will just check what will happen. So the assignment has to be like what it is assigning is, it is assigning the name to this dot name. Again, this is similar to name equal to name. Okay, so when you put this in the left side, it indicates this name is this name, and the RHS this name is this name. So when you put in an opposite way like this, now this name is not said to be this name. It is like this name, and it is assigned the same way, like name equal to name. So to avoid this, you can put this keyword in the left side. Yeah, this is a keyword in Java. It's a default keyword. So okay, so now tell me, what are all the keywords you can see in this student class? What are all the keywords you can able to see in this student class? Okay, string is not a keyword. String is it's a class in Java. So this is a keyword. Then int is not a keyword. It's similar to a keyword, but it's a data type. Set and get is said to be a method. Name, It's not a keyword. Where is CS? CS is said to be a object. It's not a keyword. Yeah, void is said to be a keyword. Yeah, class is said to be a keyword. Okay. So this, by exploring the line by line, we'll see the class is said to be a keyword. Then this is not a keyword. This is not a keyword. This is not a keyword. Then we'll have a public void. It's a keyword. This is a keyword. Then again, void is a keyword. Then void main represents the main method. Then static public is said to be a keyword. And again, new is said to be a another keyword. Okay. So now, how many of them are using system or a computer now? Okay. Okay. So now, what I will prefer is I can, if you are interested, you can share your computer and you can, I will give you a scenario so that you have to write a program so that everyone will understand the concepts. You can open your notepad and you can type. Anyone interested in doing that? Yeah. So I'm going to stop the screen. Stop sharing now so that the Meenakshi will put the share screen on and she will explain or she will put the code so that it will be good for everyone to see that. So I will stop sharing that so that you can start the share now. Okay, now you can start the share. You can select share and you can click on sharing screen. Okay, I think it's not working. So yeah, Sugumar, you can start. Okay, but I'm not going to I prefer only Notepad because this is the basic class. The people they will get confused. I just want to type the code alone so that everyone will able to see that. Okay. Okay, you can share your screen, Sugumar, if you are using computer. Okay, so the scenario is, yeah, he's sharing the screen. Okay. Okay. So the scenario is you have to write a program in Java which uses the class called employee, and you can create your own data member and member method, or you can use any method, and you have to use the keyword this. So you should maximize your notepad so that we can't able to see other steps what you are using. Yeah. So he is creating a class employee. Then he is creating public static void main, where static is a keyword. It should be in the S should be in small letter. then Java supports only string, and there should okay. There should not be any space between string and that brackets. Then he is using string name. Okay, that's fine. So what you can do is what you can do is you can assign the string name you can assign the string name outside this public static void main, like this, like what I have did. What I'm trying to say is you should assign the name string outside this public static void main after the first line. So if you assign the string name inside the public static void main, then it is said to be a local variable. But what I'm trying to ask is I'm trying to put that in put assign as the data member. So if you put here in the second line, it is said to be a data member. Yeah, then you create, yeah, you can put now you can just declare it, no need to, you just declare it, we'll just take it later. Okay, so he's directly declaring the value. So in system, S should be in capital letter. Yeah, but when you declare the name outside the public static void main, that means it is said to be a data member. So for that you have to use the object. So before system.out.println, you have to create object. So employee space some e equal to new employee. Then open close parenthesis semicolon. Then we can use system.out.println em.name. Yeah, that's good. So what he has developed is he has developed a small code. So first I would like to appreciate him. So he has created a class employee in which he has created a data member called name, and he is directly assigning the value to that data member. But in my program, I have used something called methods, and he has created public static void main method. Inside that, he has created object employee em, then system.out.println em.name. He has printed with the help of the object. So can you stop the stop sharing the screen so that I can continue to my class? Yeah. So that comes to our machine. Okay, so we'll go for the next topic. So the next topic is method overloading. So before going for method overloading, let me go with the static method. So I'm going to use this. Okay. So now there are two types of methods. One is said to be a method without return type and method with return type. So this is a method without return type. There is no return keyword. Here also there is no return keyword. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to modify this method without return type to a method with return type. I have changed void to a string. So I'm going to use the return keyword return. The name is plus name, followed by the mark is plus mark, followed by the place is plus place. So when you use method with return type, you have to put in what way you are going to return. Maybe it may be a string, it may be integer like that. I'm going to return string. So it has to use return. So the name is plus name, the mark is plus mark like that. I have used concatenation. So this is string, this is variable, again string, variable, again string, variable like that. So this will, get the details. So if I do s.getDetails, what I will just, before that I will save this. Let me compile. Let me run. So I will not get any result because the main purpose of this getDetail, it is to return the value. It is just returning the value, but it is not printing the value. So to print that, we have to use system.out.println. So let me compile it. Let me execute it. So now you will get that the name is followed by name, the mark is mark, the place is Chennai. Okay. So now we have studied that there are two types of method. One is method with return type and another one is method without return type. This is method with return type and this is method without return type. So what happens is when we use method with return type, we have to explicitly print that because it will just return the value, but it will not print the value. So when you want to print the value, you have to use system.out.println. And there is another thing called a static method. So I'm going to use the static method for this. For example, let me ask you a question. Have you understood the concept of this types of methods? Yeah, the question is, when do we use with and without a return type? So normally if you are a good programmer, you won't use this void method. You will use only this method with return type because as the course progress, we will use advanced concept where this kind of stuffs, it will be automatically generated where the method with return types will be generated. Or when you assign some value, for example, when you assign some value, we should use method without return type. For example, as I am assigning the value here, there is no way I can return any value here. I'm not going to return any value here in set details because in set details I'm just assigning. So set details is said to be void and get details is said to be a string or a return method because I'm returning some value. In previous case, we use system.out.println. We have not assigned any value. So this is one of the very good question, like when do we use with and without return type? The with return type can be used if you return some value or if you print some value. Without return type can be used when you just assign some value. Okay. What will happen if we didn't specify the return keyword? Or if you use return keyword for normal method, what happens if you use assuming that I am just commenting this, that means the compiler will not return this. So we'll just see that practically. So you'll use something called missing return statement. That means the return method must return some value. Okay. And next question is, what happens if you return something, return hello? So it will again display a error message like unexpected return value, because what we have created is we have created method without a return type, but we are returning that with the help of return keyword. So it will give an error message. So any doubt? Any doubt, you can type it in chat. Okay. So what are other way we can write the employee program? So yeah, I'm going to write a employee program for you. So which will include everything. For example, like it will have this keyword, it will have a return type method, and it will have a non-return type method like that. So first I will create a class called employee. Then I will write a public static void main, string args. So let me create some data member. For example, string ename for employee name, int eid for employee id, string address of the employee, like that. So I'm going to just create a you can use the question is, it's string array arguments, right? You can use either way, this way or this way, because the modern programmer, they will use this. Okay. So public void get detail. Then so I will use some same string ename, int id, comma string address. So then I can use this keyword, since I have used same name, ename equal to ename, this dot eid equal to eid, this dot address equal to address. So I'm going to, since like you can see, this is method without return type, because I am just performing the assignment. So I'm going to just create a return type string. Sorry, this is set details. Sorry, set. This is get. Return. The name is, or I can create like this string result equal to, the name is plus name, plus the ID is plus EID, plus addresses plus address. So what I can do is I can return the string, return res. So then I can assign the value by creating an object. So E dot set details. Then system dot out dot println. E dot get details. So I'm going to put that as employee dot Java. I'm going to compile it. Oh, there is an error. So I have given set details here. So you just modify this. E dot get details here. Oops. Okay. So I have given the name as ename and ID as EID, then address, just compile. Okay. Get details off I have to put. E dot set details, details, okay. So error, method set details in class employee cannot be applied to given types. Is that okay? So I have to assign them some value, right? I forgot to assign them. So X, Y, Z, then ID is some 123, and address is India. So I have not assigned, so it is like it's telling this error. So now you won't see any error. So Java employee, like that. Okay. So you can directly assign value here, but it is not in a good way, that good way of writing Java. So you have to either pass it to a method, or you can pass it to something called constructor. We'll just see that later, like that. So any doubt so far in class, object and methods? Any doubt? So if you use public string, it will return only string type or all type of data. Public string. So it is, the public string is nothing but, so I can put it as public or I can put private here. Normally if you put if you didn't put anything, it will, the Java will take, or normally they will put private here. If you want to put a thing, you have to put private here. So private means only this class can be used, or the ename, EID, address can be used only inside this class. But when you use an object, you can use either the set method, set details, or get details, like that. So not about dealing with public or private, but better you go for some private keyword. So any doubt, any queries? Any queries? Yeah. Can we get input in runtime, or we can only assign a default value? No, we can give the value of X, Y, Z, 1, 2, 3 and India in runtime, but that we will learn in this, the use of buffered reader. Okay, so use of buffered reader, we can get the value from the user. For example, after executing the program, Java employee, it will ask you to enter the name, and we have to type, and it has to be given during the runtime. Okay. So now we'll go for the static method and constructor. Okay, so you just tell me some application, like we have created student, we have created employee. Now you just tell me some scenario. So I will do a code by demonstrating the static method and constructor. In your chart, you just tell me some of the like scenarios where we will do that. Similar to an employee or a student. The area of methods, it's a textbook example. Just tell me some real time. Okay, area of shapes, again the textbook. It's like a textbook examples. Just tell me some book details. We can go for book details. Okay. Book details or library, anything we can go for. Okay. So let me start with a new thing called class book. In which it was having the same thing, public static void main. So I'm going to use this one. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create some name, like name of the book. Then ISBN number of the book. Then we'll have int NOP, that is number of pages. What I'm going to do is I'm going to create a method, public static get details, or you can put set details. So again, string. So in previous case, I have used something called public void set detail, but here I am going to use public static string name, then string ISBN, then int NOP. So I'll use the same thing, this dot. This dot name equal to name. This dot ISBN equal to ISBN. This dot NOP equal to NOP. Okay. So I'm going to just print the method using another method called get detail. So I'm going to put that as static again. Yeah, I will tell you the thing. Why we are using static instead of void. I will explain you what we are going to use that. Details. So it is like public static void. Sorry, it's public static void. Okay. So in previous case we used public void get details, and we are going to use extra keyword static, not omitting the void. I forgot to say that. And it's like public static void get detail, public static void get details, like that. System dot out dot println. You can print the name. I'm just directly printing the name without any the content. So this will print name followed by ISBN followed by maybe I can put some space. Okay. So name followed by ISBN followed by NOP. Now you can see there are three methods: public static void get details, public static void get set details, then public static void get details, then public static void name. Now the concept is we are going to learn the concept of static. Okay. So If we specify the method name as the static, for example, public void set details and public void get details, and if you are not using any static if you don't use the static keyword, how will you call this method in public static void? Can you just put it in chat? The question is very simple. If you are not using any static method, how will you call that static method inside the public static void main or inside the main method? How will you do that? The question is, if you don't use any static method, for example, public void set details or public void get details, how will you call or how will you assign the value in the main method? Okay, using set or get details. So the first thing is, what you will do in the first line after public static void main? No, it's to print that you will use system.out.println. My question is, first the answer is, first we have to create an object for it. If there is no static method, we have to create an object, like for example employee emp equal to new employee, like that. But here there is no non-static method, or there is no it's not like a previous method. So what you can do is, you can directly you can set detail, you can directly call that method set details, and you can assign the value ISBN 123, then in number of pages is 350, like that. So there is no use of creating an object, because we are going to use the static method. Then we'll use get details. So I'm going to save this book.java. Compile it. Oh. Okay. So you have to make this one also static. Oh. Okay. So we should not use, I think, this keyword. Let me just check. Okay. So there is an extra thing we have to do. The static methods can access only the static variables. For example, this is static method. It can access only the static variables, and we should not able to use this keyword also. So for what we can do is, we can just change some name here. So that we'll just assign some value like name equal to name, n, ISBN equal to I, and NOP equal to N, like that. Oops. Okay, so there is multiple declaration, or I can put name in A, like that. Okay. So I'm getting the result. So the main thing in static method is, if you create any method in with the help of the static method, there is no need for any object creation. And one more thing, like Vikram said in the chat, the static method can have access only to the static members. For example, this static method set detail and this static method get details can have only access to the static variables. For example, static name, static string ISBN, and static int NOB. And similarly, we should not use the keyword this in static, because when we use this, this specifies the current instance, and also this specifies the object creation, but we are not going to create any object here. Since we are not creating any object, we have just we have to just give a different name. For example, name, for name I am giving NA, for ISBN number I have given I, and for the NOP, the number of page, I have given N, and we can assign the value like this. Okay, so this is all about the static method and the static variable. So static method is nothing but, if you use any static method, we can call the static method without creating an object. Or sometimes you can use like this also. For example, book dot set details, then book dot get details. So we can call the static method like this. Class name dot static method name, or simply static method name. Okay, so we can call by using class name or dot method name, or simply you can call by method name. So I have modified the program. Let me just check. Yeah, it's good. Okay, any doubt in static method and static variable? Any doubt? Yeah, we can assign the value to the static method like this. For example, I'm not going to call this set detail. So I'm going to assign the value directly, name equal to So the static method, again, we can directly assign the value inside the main method. So you can use book.name, book.isbn, or book.nop. Okay. So I will explain this again. So first we are creating a class called book, and then I am creating three static methods. Sorry, static variables like name, ISBN, and NOP, and I am creating a two method. One is static void set detail and static void get detail. And the main purpose of static method is, if you create any method as a static, we no need to create an object for that particular class. You can directly call that method either by class name dot method name, or you can just put a method name. Similarly, we can assign the value of the static method directly like this. Either you can use book.name equal to xyz or name equal to xyz. So since this is not a correct way of writing a program, and I am assigning the value with help of the static method setDetail. Okay. So this book.setDetail represents the setDetail. And it will pass XYZ, ISBN 123 and 350 here. And this will assign to a static variable name, ISBN and NOP. And it will get assigned. And then we can directly call the static method. Okay. So any doubt in this program? Maybe if you want, again, I will explain. Any doubt in static method, static variables? Yeah. Yeah, the why using static in variables, because the static method can access only the static variables. It will not access the non-static variable. For example, so what I have did is I have did like this previously. You can see the error. Non-static variable name cannot be referenced from a static context. That means this static method can access only the static variables. So I am changing that as static yeah. If we assign two book details in a program, why is the first detail only be displayed? So we can, because there is no object creation here, because when you create object, you can have a multiple object. So this multiple object can have a multiple method, but this is a static method which in which there is no process of creating an object. So it will just display what you did for the previous one, or it will just display XYZ like this. Okay, or we will just try like creating this one. We create another book detail, maybe ABC, ISBN 111, another book detail, 250 page. We'll just check. That's okay. So if you want to have another book, you have to just book.setDetails ABC like that, and you have to just get detail. So first you have to complete for the book one, then you have to go for book two. And one more thing I want to add, that this kind of static methods and static variables, the programmer, like, they won't use much of the static method and static variable. You no need to get panic about the static method and static variable. But what in Java, some predefined classes, they use static variable and static method. So I have demonstrated you like to show what is the use of static method and static variable, etc. So this is the way. So if there is a static method or static variable, there is no need of creating a class or creating an object. Sorry. So you have any doubt in static method and static variable? Any doubt? Guys, any doubt you have? Any doubt? Okay. So now the time is 7:58. We'll take a break up to maybe we can take 15 minutes break, and we can come back and we can write some code, because we have did plenty of code and we may get some. You need to get some rest. So we'll come back at maybe at 15 minutes late. Oh, sorry. Maybe at 15 minutes later. So we'll come back at 8:15. So we'll come back at 8:15 p.m. Okay.